You're watching member-supported GPTV, your PBS station, bringing you the best.
The following program is an exclusive presentation of GPTV.
Georgia Public Television presents the Georgia High School Association State Basketball Championship. Major funding for this program is made possible in part by Georgia's Electric Membership Corporations, IBEW Local 613, South Trust Bank, The Kroger Company, Dodge, State Farm Insurance, the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, the Atlanta Journal-Constitution, and by Powerade.
Live from the Macon Coliseum, it's the girls' AAA basketball state championship featuring the Gainesville Red Elephants and the Perry Panthers. Eight games down, two more to go as championship weekend rolls on here on GPTV. Welcome back, everybody. I'm Jim Giannacchio. The Red Elephants won state championships in 94 and 2001. Perry is looking for their first state title. Two people to call it courtside, Dave Gardner and Teresa Edwards.
All right, thanks, Jim. Again, we're here with four-time Olympic gold medalist Teresa Edwards as we get ready for AAA girls action. Indeed, Gainesville, a team that's been here before, as Jim said, and Perry, a team riding a lot of momentum. They're coming off a big minor upset victory, I guess, over Westminster last night, who came into that game 30-0. So Perry, nonetheless, ready to rock and roll. A lot of good athletes on the court.
Perry upset queens of the tournament. They upset a Westminster undefeated team this season. Also, you got Gainesville. Average winning margin is 35 points a game. So it's going to be an interesting game, and I think they can make it happen. And this is the big girl that's going to make it happen if it's going to happen tonight, averaging 20 points, 9 rebounds, 3 assists, and 3 block shots a game. She's missed everything, All-State, All-America, if you ask me.
Yeah, arguably the best player in the state of Georgia right now and one of them in the country. And they're going to look at the starting five. Lauren Niles getting the start underneath. Hendricks, Humphrey, Westmoreland, and Mandy Smith, number 22. The senior that are getting the start. The five on the floor for the Gainesville Red Elephants. And there you get a look at the Perry Lady Panthers.
That's number 11, Fatima Stripling, averaging 10 points a game, 6 rebounds, 1 assist, 2 steals. She's the senior leader. She's going to be all over the court. She's going to work hard all night. She's part of the upset squad.
And there you get a look. Shantina Davis, Stripling. And that is Marimi Davis, number 33, Williams and Mitchell, the five on the floor for the Panthers. Let's go ahead and join our PA announcer for the starting lineups.
The home team.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event.
Attention for the starting lineup. First for Gainesville. At forward, a 5'9" junior, number 14, Taurus Hendricks. At forward, a 6'3" junior, number 32, Tasha Humphrey. At center, a 5'10" junior, number 34, Lauren Niles. At guard, a 5'4" senior, number 22, Mandy Smith. At guard, a 5'4" senior, number 21, Sarah Westmoreland. And your Gainesville head coach, Manson Hill. And now for your Perry Panthers. At forward, a 5'9" senior, number 11, Fatima Stripling. At forward, a 5'10" junior, number 21, Shantina Davis. At guard, a 5'8" senior, number 22, Cassie Mitchell. At guard, a 5'6" junior, number 24, Runikia Williams. At center, a 6-foot junior, number 33, Marima Davis. And your Perry head coach, John Chance. Your referee for tonight's game, Mr. Bill McNair.
Well, there you have it. Triple A action set and ready from the Macon Centerplex live right here on GPTV. Girls, Triple A action coming up next.
Broadcast of GHSA basketball on GPTV is made possible in part by the following corporate partners. You're watching the GHSA basketball state championships on GPTV.
Girls state championship of the weekend getting ready. First, let's throw it down to our man on the baseline. That's John Nelson.
Thanks, Dave. A couple of quick notes. Let's start with the Perry Panthers. John Chance, it's his first year ever coaching women's basketball, and all he knew about Tasha Humphrey coming into today was that she was, in his words, a really good player. Fashion statement where Gainesville's concerned. Look at head coach Manson Hill. That's the same outfit that he was wearing yesterday. Same tie. He hasn't lost wearing that tie at all this season, and this is how he's going to try and finish the streak for this entire season. Back to you guys.
Well, hey, superstitions, I guess. Sometimes, you know, you take them where you want them to go, I guess.
No, I don't fool with that one.
Well, speaking of streaks, Perry has won 16 straight ball games, so they're looking to keep that streak going. And we are underway. Triple-A girls action live in Macon. And a little back and forth there on the opening tip as the Lady Panthers in white. Control the basketball.
If that's any indication of how the game's going to be, we don't know yet.
Congratulations to Mitchell Baker's boys who won the AA championships. As we get a look at our officials there, McNair, Engel, and Frankie Harper on the floor for this AAA championship. Shot off the mark there, brought down by Niles of Gainesville, and the Lady Elephants bring it across. Number 21, Sarah Westmoreland, does a lot of the ball handling for Gainesville.
Interesting matchup on the ball, playing Tasha Humphrey.
Humphrey from outside takes the first shot in and out of there, and you'll see Humphrey, a big girl like her, normally playing inside, but she can hit from all over the floor.
No, she's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. She's the first high school player I ever seen that could play five positions.
Meanwhile, the Lady Panthers on the other end trying to counter. That's Shantina Davis, 21 with it up top.
Gainesville will definitely play a zone. Perry doesn't, they have the reputation of not being a great outside shooting team, so they will definitely force the issue, penetrate a lot against this zone tonight.
Several Davises on the roster. Four Davises on the roster for Perry. Two of them out there right now. As Tassie Mitchell pulls up a little baseline and hits.
Nice shot. Tassie's one of their premier shooters that they do have on the outside.
First points of the ball game. Lady Panthers lead it 2-0. That's Niles with it. Over to Mandy Smith. Thought about pulling the trigger from three-point land there, but held up. Humphrey guarded, and they're going to get Williams for a push there.
I'll tell you what, Rianika Williams has her work cut out for her. Guarding Tasha is going to be a really big job tonight.
That is quite a task.
She's so outsized.
Westmoreland underneath into Niles. Won't go. And back the other way, Perry off and running, 2-on-2. And good hustle by Westmoreland, getting back in transition.
Good hustle, great defense, way to get a hand in there and break up that fast break.
Coach Manson Hill, and there you get a look at that tie, the good luck tie, if you will. Coach Hill in his 15th season at Gainesville.
Well, he has Tasha Humphrey on his team, man. How much luck do you need?
Tina Davis driving, puts up a floater there in the lane, won't go. Ball still loose underneath, and a foul going to be called. That's Marima Davis, number 33, the junior, who went up with it there, averaging 13 points this year. She's really been the big scorer.
She has been awesome throughout the playoffs and the tournament. She scored 19 points just last night in a big game. She will be a big factor tonight, her and Tasha in the paint.
misses on the first free throw attempt there. Perry, of course, out of region 4 AAA. As you get a look at Davis, he shoots the second of two and hits on that one, so 1-for-2 on that trip for Davis. Backcourt pressure now by Perry. They get it in there, Niles across midcourt.
Surprisingly looking like seeing Perry put it on that full court press then, and Gainesville just went straight over the top of it, and that was a simple pass, and they completed that.
Mandy Smith missing the three on the other end. Shantina Davis back in the lane, kicks it out. Three-point shot for Tassie Mitchell, too strong. And Humphrey with the board brings it down now ahead.
Great outlet pass.
Niles puts it up and in.
Nice.
Tough shot by Lauren Niles.
That was a great finish, great court awareness by Tasha Humphrey getting that ball out quick.
She's been big all year long, and Gainesville's a team that does have some depth. We'll see Shamika Shirley and Rhonda Demps, Keita Waller. Though the big story, a freshman, has really been the hero for Gainesville in these playoffs along with Humphrey. And foul going to be called on Humphrey right there. Do you think that's kind of maybe some strategy tonight for Perry? Maybe try to take it to Tasha, get her in foul trouble? I mean, what do you do with
it? Well, I would. I mean, that would be the smart thing to do. And all Tasha really had to do was keep her hands straight. She was definitely in great position to make a clean block. But since she reached over, she created the foul. But, of course, they should definitely, Perry should attack him as soon as possible and as much as possible.
Marimi Davis back at the line, misses on the first one.
I don't think Marima Davis is anything, you know, a slouch or anything. I think she's done a great job to average 13 points all season long. She can make it happen.
2 of 4 in 2 trips at the free throw line for Davis. And now that one going to be kicked away. Last touch, though, by Perry. Lady Panthers 29-2. As you can look at Coach John Chance, first season at the helm and right here in the state championship. You got to love that.
Hey, Coach, you better renew that contract right now.
And there you get a look at number 23 there for Gainesville into the lineup. That is Keita Waller, the freshman that we were just talking about.
He's coming along very well, playing really well for Gainesville.
Had 10 points in round 3 against Elbert County, had 11 in the semifinal matchup against Dodge County, in which Gainesville won 65-28. Air ball there.
She's not quite the microwave yet. Not going to come in and score that quick from that far out, I don't think. Unless you are the microwave.
Talking about tradition, of course, Perry with 16 straight wins, but their boys and girls programs have really taken off. They've been solid throughout the years and always an excellent job done by those Perry coaches. There's a shot from outside, three-point shot, Shantina Davis off the mark, and Westmoreland grabs it. Humphrey will bring it across. Their girl runs the floor a little bit. She'll take it all the way.
Oh.
It's going to draw the foul there. Good hard foul by Davis, not shying away at all there.
It wasn't a smart foul. She wasn't in position. I think she must have got frustrated with Natasha getting by her, but that was really not a smart foul. She was already beat. She should have let it go. She's going to be a big factor in the game. Shantina Davis needs to stay focused, make some smart decisions, because her team really needs her, especially with her penetration that she gives them in the half court. Just given that last shot, if she'd be a little patient and wait on that outside shot as opposed to looking in between the gaps, penetrate and looking for something to happen, because, you know, they're not going to knock down these outside shots that easy.
Humphrey 2 of 2 on that last trip. And that one stolen away by Mandy Smith. Nice job by the Lady Elephants on defense there. Get that turnover. Now they're in position inside. Humphrey. Spin move there. Knocked away. And it will be Perry basketball. Lady Panthers come up with it. Last touch by Gainesville.
It's almost like you're waiting for Tasha Humphrey to just take off here in a second. She makes some good moves. She's definitely getting opportunities to put the ball up in great position.
She's averaging well over 20 points on the year, and a lot of folks don't realize this. She's only a junior.
Yeah, I know.
They're going to have to contend with her next
year. She's been around a long time, too.
Looking inside there, Marimi Davis keeping that ball alive there. It kicks it back out to Mitchell.
Tell you what, Davis has given her a job to work with in the paint there.
Into the corner. Mitchell thought about the three. Now back on the other end, Williams. And back up top to Davis. You know, we've seen a lot of good basketball players, girls basketball players throughout the years in the state of Georgia, seeing some of the best ones here in the last years or two. You know, Sherrill Baker and you know, Sparkle Davis at Paideia, and of course the Boston girl Westminster. But to tell you what, Tasha Humphrey is certainly grabbing a lot of headlines. It just seems like kind of goes back to what we were talking about in that double-A game about the level of competition in girls basketball.
Great effort on defense getting back.
Look at that.
Great.
Nice block by Davis.
Tassia actually set that up. Flying in the air.
Inside, Humphrey going to draw the foul. They're going to call it on Tassie Mitchell, her first. And the team's third.
Some early fouls coming in here with some big-time players. Could be a key factor later in the game.
Look at Coach Chance, of course, Perry, making her way through state, beating Westside Augusta, Tattnall County, Westover in round three, and then the semifinals, 50-48 over Westminster, a team that was 30-0 coming in. That was a school record wins for Westminster.
It's a very good team. Great bunch of young women. Play very hard.
5-4. Gainesville with a one-point lead. Back on the other end. That was Stripling, who followed her own miss, but unable to get the putback there. But Davis keeps it alive, and that one knocked away. And a foul going to be called now on Keita Waller. A lot of balance, a lot of speed on this Perry team. Very quick, very athletic.
They are very quick, very athletic. I'm waiting for them to really become really aggressive on the offensive end of the court to really attack. But they're gonna keep Shatina up top, and she's gonna handle that ball majority of this game, and she's gonna look to penetrate. That's just their game plan.
Mitchell looking inside. They've got Davis underneath. And she hits. Marimi Davis.
Well, they can always go to Plan B. Get it inside to Davis.
Little backcourt pressure here by Perry. That's Mandy Smith, who's able to dribble across. Penetrate. Inside there, looking to get it into Waller. Ball loose. Jump ball. Possession arrow will stay with Gainesville.
That was a great push by Mandy Smith. She had a great opportunity looking under the basket, trying to create it. Draw some attention so she could get that ball to her teammate and get that layup. Just got a hand on it.
Westmoreland puts it in play from underneath their own goal there. Waller back on top to Mandy Smith. Smith, a senior. Certainly been a good floor leader for this Lady Elephant team. Gainesville with a lot of history, too, on the boys and girls sides of the court.
Well, Smith is a very solid, confident player. Not to take any credit from her Tasha's teammates, because she actually feels like she has a much better team. And they all have contributed and have a great season together. I actually asked Tasha which team she'd prefer to play last night, and she said she really wanted a chance to play Westminster, but it didn't matter because her team was playing so well.
And last three by Amanda Smith off the mark. Off the inbound, though. Waller's there.
Nice shot.
Check that. That was Lauren Niles, number 34, with another bucket. A little bit of pressure there by Gainesville momentarily. Shantina Davis on the other end lays it up too strong. Stripling trying to get the follow and another jump ball and possession arrow this time to Perry.
The type of player Stripling is, she will be scrappy. She will be around the boards. She'll be around loose balls.
And you got to look at Ashley Fairfax there, number 15, the hero of last night's semifinal game, hitting a big three-point shot from the corner.
The courage it took for her to throw up a three-pointer at that point in time in the game, I tell you.
And she had been having trouble breaking the press and doing some other things, but Coach Chance stuck with her.
Yes, he did. Westminster put a lot of pressure on her. She had many, many turnovers last night, and she really kept her head in the game.
Perry with the turnover. Davis. And that's Mitchell, who puts it up. Let quite go. Ball still loose. And I believe they're going to get Westmoreland for the foul. That'll be her first.
Perry's really struggling, trying to find some type of offense, some type of continuity to get into the game. They're really looking like they're a little frustrated, and I think Tasha's definitely causing problems in the paint. But execution is going to be a key factor here. Execute, just execute your plays and see what happens.
Fairfax up top over to Davis in the corner. And they'll reset up top. 1:15 to go in the opening quarter in the AAA Girls State Championship. Off the mark there by Stripling. Humphrey brings it down. She'll bring it across.
She will pull up a three. Nice little crossover.
There. That one might have been partially tipped her. I don't know, but it was short of the basket. And Perry off and running on the other end under a minute to go. And that shot by Davis off the mark, too strong off the glass. And Gainesville with it. Now down court on the other end, Mandy Smith. On the receiving end of that Humphrey pass.
Smart decision by Mandy. Set it up, get under control, get your team together. Nice job.
Slower pace, low scoring first quarter, just 7-6 here. 34 seconds left. And a whistle away from the ball.
Tasha asked the official to call that one. Like, look. She was down to her knees, Gardner.
Foul on Fairfax. And a little bit of a size mismatch there, I guess, between those two. But, you know, she's not going to back down. Fairfax, a sophomore.
Just doesn't seem to matter who's guarding. I tell you, it's going to be a size advantage given to Tasha Humphrey. A little frustration on Shatina Davis. She's missed a lot of shots. She's, you know, there's no need for her to get out of character, pick up a weak foul like that, because Tasha's going to be here all game. So she needs to stay on the court for her team.
Humphrey right around, I guess, about 6'3" or so.
Definitely. Or so, every bit of 6'3" or more.
Another whistle there. Foul going to be called once again on Perry. And the Lady Panthers picking up some quick fouls here. That one on Stripling. Perry, of course, coming into this matchup, the number 4 team in the state. Gainesville ranked 5th. Both teams have pretty much been there all year long in that top 5, top 10. As Marimi Davis steps back in for Perry, and Stripling will take a seat. 30 seconds left here in quarter number 1. And a turnaround off the inbound, and a tough shot there by Taurus Hendricks.
Nice execution on an out-of-bounds play. So he just turned around, converted a nice bucket.
Back on the other end now, 16 seconds left. Knocked away. Hendricks trying to come up with the steal there. Couldn't quite keep it in play, though, but a nice effort.
Gainesville's building the momentum. They're feeling confident. They're playing really great defense. Hands in the passing lane. They're moving and communicating.
Davis off the inbound. Lays it up and in.
With Tasha Humphrey sitting on the bench with his last 30 seconds. That was an easy. She just pulled that from the top.
And a shot. Still a couple seconds left there. I don't think Westmoreland had to heave that thing up quite so quick. There's still a second on the clock. And kind of goes back to what we were talking about in that first game. These teams used to have it scoreboards at their home gyms. But here in Macon, of course, you got the big one right there in the middle. And they're unable to see the time there. So it's kind of deceiving. Let's go ahead and take a timeout. That's the end of one. 9-8. Gainesville with a 1-point lead. We'll be right back with quarter number 2 right after this.
Broadcast of GHSA basketball on GPTV is made possible in part by the following corporate partners.
You're watching GPTV, bringing you the best.
You're watching the GHSA basketball state championships on GPTV.
Dave Garner and Teresa Edwards back with you here in the girls' AAA championship. Gainesville with a 1-point lead after a quarter. Let's go ahead and throw it on down to John Nelson. John, what's going on?
Thanks, Dave. Just spend a little time in both huddles as we get ready for the next 8 minutes. Manson Hill of Gainesville basically said they have 3 offensive rebounds. We have none. We've got to get to the boards offensively. Where Perry's concerned, they were saying, don't be such in a rush to close the deal. We've got the lead. We've got plenty of time in this ball game. Back to you.
All right, and Humphrey with just 3 points in that first quarter, 0-for-3 from the field. There you can look at the field goal situation there.
That's what's really curious. I mean, I'm curious about right now is why both teams are struggling. I don't know if it's jitters or what.
And you get a look at Humphrey there off the pass, follows her own miss, and lays it in there.
I think the 30 seconds at the end of the last quarter is going to help her to really think about what's going on after going 0-for-3 in the first quarter.
That is a good question. As we mentioned, you know, a lot of lower scoring ball games this year. I don't know. Good defense. Paces have certainly been quick. They've been up and down the floor, but not a lot of field goals. There's a bank shot there.
There's some
Tina Davis.
A nice drop. A nice little jumper she can.
Back on the other end. Gainesville with the numbers 2-on-1. Swatted away by Marimi Davis.
I like that block.
Little authority there. Stripling on the other end, knocked away from behind. Good hustle by Gainesville, but a big play defensively on the other end by Perry.
Not only a good block, that's not only a good block, she came up with the steal. That's great basketball playing right there.
Off the inbound, knocked away there, but Cassie Mitchell in position for it. Shantina Davis with it. Looking inside, trying to work it in there to Davis. Knocked away, taken away by Humphrey.
It's going to be really hard for them to lob that ball into the paint all night with Tasha in there. So they're going to have to get out and make some really solid bounce passes and get the ball in the post.
Forcing the issue a little bit there. So Perry with it. In region 7 AAA is where Gainesville plays. 7 AAA against 4 AAA right here. Davis trying to work it inside there, knocked away.
They're double teaming Davis in the paint. We got Shantina Davis trying to pass to the other Davis inside the paint, but she's really getting too close. They're double teaming her as soon as she gets the ball, and she's trying to go over the top. If she backs it out, creates some space, she'll really have an opportunity to make a nice bounce pass, and it'll be a one-on-one with Tasha and Davis in the paint.
Back on the other end there. Lady Elephant's able to break it. The little shot there, too strong, won't go. Perry back and running on the other end. 11-10, still a one-point ball game. Pull-up jumper, not there. The follow, Mitchell puts it up, too strong. And Gainesville comes out of there with it. Meg Henson, number 12.
I'll tell you what, Perry's not shy about shooting.
Nope. Got to keep putting it up.
Tasha's causing problems. Anytime you shoot it in her area, she's throwing people's shots off.
And that one tipped away. Back the other way now. Perry with the turnover. That's Mitchell.
Great.
Who wins a foot race to the hole there. Tassie Mitchell with the bucket.
That's Perry's game. They play the full court defense, trying to create the turnover so that they can have fast break opportunities just like that.
And Westmoreland lost the handle on it. It'll go back the other way. So Perry making the most of some turnovers here in the second quarter. And that's going to get a timeout called by Coach Manson Hill. 30-second timeout called by the Gainesville Lady Elephants, who come into this matchup at 29-3 overall. But we hope you're enjoying this broadcast of the GHSA Class AAA Girls State Championship. And you can show your appreciation and support by becoming a member of GPTV. It's easy and totally secure. Log on to our website at www.gpb.org. And thanks for supporting high school sports on GPTV. Let's go ahead and throw it on down once again to John Nelson.
Really quick, you who talked about jitters, it's probably half right. Where Gainesville's concerned, they purposefully played a tough schedule. And remember, their regionals were in the dome, so they're used to goofy lights and bigger crowds. Where Perry's concerned, Ashley Fairfax actually had headaches yesterday because of the stress of the ball games here in the Macon Coliseum. So it's for Perry, yes. Gainesville, not so much. Guys, back to you.
That's a good point. There's a nice little shot there by Shantina Davis, who gets another one to go off the glass.
Another big basket. She had a big game yesterday as well. Good thing. I'm glad to see her calm down and make these things happen on the offensive end for Perry.
Foul on the other end there. As John said, a tough schedule for Gainesville this year. They actually played Westminster a little earlier in the season. A lot of folks have penciled in the Lady Wildcats as the state champion this year after being 30-0. Perry, of course, knocking them off last night. And that's another thing, too. These teams are turning around after one night. They played last night. Normally, they've all been on Thursday. They've had a day or so to prepare in the championship. This year, though, AAA, quick turnaround.
Yeah, I'm sure that's going to play a factor as the game goes along, too.
Got to wonder how those legs are going to hold up in that fourth quarter.
Well, you got to understand that everyone has to go through it, so only the strong is going to survive this one.
Lauren Niles at the line, missing on the first. And is able to hit the second one there, one of two on the trip. Of course, I guess, you know, throughout the year, you're used to playing that Friday-Saturday schedule in a lot of cases, especially with tournaments and things like
exactly,
that.
Exactly.
So
yeah.
Shouldn't be too much of a transition.
Hey, they're kids. They're young. They can run all day. Oh, my God.
What is going on?
That was a rainbow jumper off the glass.
Ridiculous.
Shots.
Big three-point shot there. It's 16-12. Perry with a four-point lead. 5 minutes to go in the half. They like that glass here on his last few shots.
Got to say, we're quite surprised to see Perry in the lead at this moment in the game, I tell you.
Niles with it up top, gets rid of it. Henson, just a sophomore in there, number 12, and a shot outside, and that's a three-point shot for Torres Hendricks.
Big shot.
5 points now for Hendricks, the junior.
She was ready, waiting on that shot. She definitely looked like she was going to make it.
Oh, look at that ball work inside, Davis.
That was great ball movement, great passes.
Going to draw the foul there. That's one of those where you want the bucket and the foul if you can get it to go, but couldn't quite get that shot to fall.
That was definitely an and-one opportunity. Great awareness, good ball movement. Good reads back there.
Ball never touched the floor.
Exactly, reading the defense.
Davis back at the line, 2 of 4 in the early going. The junior averaging 13 points this year. And off the back of the iron on the first one.
You got a feeling that Davis is going to get fouled a lot. He's got to start draining these free throws. It's going to be a factor. This is not the game that you want to take that lightly. Not that stat column. If you're going to get a free throw and it's free, nail it.
Take a look at Davis with 6 points so far, 3 boards. The team is dribbling back into the ballgame for Perry. Meanwhile, Mandy Smith and Catherine Hurst in for Gainesville. And
these bank jump shots and free throws, I'm for it. If they'll go, I'm for
they
it.
They found out they didn't have to call them, you know, so they're going right to it. That time, Westmoreland just kept that ball alive. Humphrey for 3 off the front of the iron. No good. Mandy Smith gets it out of there and resets for Gainesville.
Perry's doing a really, really good job containing Tasha Humphrey, which is very surprising when we're in this game tonight. Tasha's beginning to feel the pressure of not scoring for her team. She's bringing it down on the offense in the end, facing the pressure, and she's looking to score. And that's going to be a bit much right now until she let herself get into a rhythm of play.
Humphrey just 1 of 6 from the field here in this first half.
And when you're used to scoring 20-plus points a game, that can be quite frustrating early in the game.
Cassie Mitchell with the bucket there for Perry, and the lead is back to 4 now. And a foul going to be called on Mitchell, it looks like, her second.
Cassie's one of those scrappy hustle players. If they had 10 fouls to give, she plays like she has them. Because she is going to be all over. She's not letting herself be intimidated because she's very confident about her team. And why not? You're looking at a team with Perry, and you got 1, 2, 3, 4 starters that average double figures. I think maybe we've been sleeping on them, but they've had a great year and they've had a good team.
Without a doubt, Ashley Fairfax in the lineup. That's 18 fouls, 1 and 1. Still for the Lady Elephants as Humphrey gets the first one to fall. There you look at Tasha Humphrey tonight. And 2 of 2. So 7 points for Humphrey, and most of that has come at the free throw line. Back to a 2-point game, 3:42 to play.
Gainesville extended their D, came up with a big steal.
Mandy Smith short on the shot, though, but the Lady Elephants keep it alive. Smith up top with it.
I like the ball in Mandy's hands. She seems to have really, really good control of this team.
Humphrey, 4-3. Once again short, Lauren Niles there on the follow, draws the foul.
See Davis jerks her hands back, but it's too late. You know, Davis, you can't be behind someone. They will not give you a block shot from behind. Believe that one.
And out of there for Niles. And here's your look. That's the break king, number 14, the sophomore who checks in. And a 30-second timeout going to be called as you get a look at Niles there. So both teams wanting to talk things over here. 3:19 to go. 1-point lead for Perry. We talk about the level of competition. Of course, Gainesville playing not only Westminster and some non-region teams, but when you look at the region that they're in. Fannin County is a team that was ranked in the top 10. East Hall was 10th, so a lot of good competition in that area. And it's hard enough just making it through your region schedule. And then you've got teams like Westminster and folks like that you're playing along the way as well. So they certainly have to feel like they're prepared coming into this one. But Perry, very athletic, maybe the most athletic team they've faced all year.
It may be a factor that the margin of victory of 35 points plus a game, winning so easy all season long, winning even coming up into this point in last night's game, they won quite easy. You know, in the face of a team like Perry, who has a momentum, playing very well together, playing very confident, has upset some teams, and rightly so, deserves to be in this championship game. They're not just going to roll over and give it to them.
That one off the back of the iron there. Hurst keeps it alive, too strong, though, on the board. And Fairfax out of there with it. Ashley Fairfax, the sophomore, of course, hitting that big 3-point shot last night in the semifinal win over Westminster, 50-48. And Fairfax from outside, a little short on that one.
They're doing some great things. They're doing the right thing. That was a great read of kicking the ball out to the open player. She did the right thing taking the shot. You just got to find a way to put it in the basket.
So Gainesville with it now. Triple-A Girls State Championship. They've garnered along with Teresa Edwards. four-time gold medalist, five-time Olympian, former Bulldog.
There you go, aging me again.
Former could mean anything. That could mean any year, though.
I know. It's just five Olympics.
Well, you know, I guess that does.
Yeah, once again, I think Tasha should consider going into paint, getting a rhythm of play, allowing herself to be a little more aggressive and get those baskets that are close in and more confident building and trying to get your game going from three-point range.
Davis missing Niles on the other end. Kicks it back out to Westmoreland. Back up top to Hurst, who pulls the trigger off the mark. And traveling going to be called on King, who got tangled up there with Davis. So the ball will come right back down the floor. Coach Chance, Perry. And a turnover there, and last touched off the back of Tasha Humphrey, so Perry will end up with the ball anyway.
Turnovers are mounting up. Both teams.
Now, when you take a look at what Humphrey's done in the playoffs, 24 points against Towers as you look at the turnover picture there. Gainesville with seven, Perry with five.
They're mounting up, and they're going to make a big difference by the end of this game. Both teams need to take control and take care of that ball.
Back on the other end, Williams almost lost the handle on that one. Back up top now. As you were saying, Humphrey, 24 points against Towers in round two, 19 rebounds in that ball game, and 21 points against Elbert County and 27 in the semis last night against Dodge.
Ooh, they're making some really long, lofty passes that can easily get picked off. They got to really take care of the ball.
Shot from outside off the mark and taken away. That's Waller who came up with it. Humphrey pushes ahead. Mandy Smith saves it.
That was a great pass. It got to Mandy. Just couldn't control it.
And a foul going to be called on the Lady Elephants. Going to be on Niles. Some folks work their whole life to get to this point as a state championship coach, and Coach John Chance in his first season.
It's a little too easy, huh?
I tell you what.
We won't say he didn't work for it.
No, I know. He's done a great job. Probably hasn't even sunk in yet. Fairfax with the basketball. Things getting physical. Knocked away inside. Humphrey up with it.
Perry struggling in their offense once again.
And Humphrey puts up the shot. Ooh. Hits. Tasha Humphrey.
Nice little hesitation in the middle of the paint. Just lofted up there. Made that look quite easy.
9 points for Humphrey. Only her second field goal, though, of this first half. 2 of 10.
But still good. She needs to get inside the paint, take a little soft jumpers as opposed to trying to force her game on the outside perimeter in three-point range.
That one taken away by Humphrey. Gainesville, 1 point lead, 20-19. Under 30 seconds to play in the half. Spin move. Oh, nice pass underneath.
Great read.
Foul.
Tasha knew she drummed at least two or three defenders, and the man was wide open. That was a great, great feed there.
Humphrey's been more of a quarterback tonight, making a lot of those long passes down the floor.
She does carry and wears a lot of different hats on this team. She does and do whatever she has to do and play whatever position she has to play night in and night out, so she's very used to it.
Williams back in for Perry. And Hurst back in for Gainesville. Niles missing on the first. And a second one off, so out of there, but Hurst, good hustle, can't get the shot to go. On the boards there. And Lady Panthers back and running the other way, 12 seconds now.
Could be a nice possession going in the halftime.
Lady Panthers trailing by one, trying to play for the final bucket and the lead, and they got it right there.
Nice rainbow shot.
Renukia Williams with his shot.
That's great going into halftime with a big shot like that. They'll come out with more confidence, I'm sure.
So the Perry Lady Panthers from Perry, Georgia, with a one-point lead, 21-20 over Gainesville. The Lady Elephants led most of that first half, but Perry with the lead right there on that bucket. Let's watch that again. That was a beautiful shot.
That was beautiful. She had a high arc on that shot. There's no way it wasn't going in.
Let's go ahead and throw it on down to John Nelson, who's standing by with Coach
Dave, thank you a lot. You know, you're making this look easy so far. Great collapsing defense, and you're keeping them in check so far, Gainesville, where they're concerned offensively.
Girls played hard, rotating through defensively, trying to let girls take turns on her, keep fresh legs on her. They've done a great job. Man, she's a great ball player. Every one of them have had to work hard just to compete with her.
Was it as what you were going to expect where Tasha was concerned?
Or? Oh, no doubt about it. She's smooth as silk. She handles the ball well. She's tough to contain. We got to keep that same type effort right there for the second half.
And then you're going to late the late jumper before the buzzer. Now it looks like you've got the momentum heading to the second 16 minutes.
Oh, that was a great shot by Nene. It was a big lift for us offensively. Once again, I thought we started to get stagnant a little bit on offense. But we're moving the ball better, and hopefully we can get some shots to fall.
All right, head coach John Chance, go back in, do some work. He's got the one-point lead as we head to the second half. Back to you, Dave.
All right, the Lady Panthers out of 4 AAA. Take it on Gainesville for the AAA championship. We'll be back after this.
Broadcast of GHSA basketball on GPTV is made possible in part by the following corporate partners. You're watching the GHSA basketball state championships on GPTV.
And welcome back to the Macon Coliseum halftime. Perry leads Gainesville 21-20. There you see the boys warming up for the 3A championship to follow. That's Hart County and East Hall. Jim Giannacchio with you on championship weekend. This is game 9. We have one more to follow, and then we wrap up championship weekend right here on GPTV. For now, let's go downstairs to John Nelson. John.
Thanks, G. It's game 9, but for me, it's principals 5 and 6. Bobby Griffin of Perry High School, Dave Shoemake of Gainesville High School. We'll start over here with the rookie and ask how things are going with you so far. Let's talk about Perry and how Perry High School is kind of, how surprising is this, how cool is this that you guys have made it here to the Coliseum?
Well, we knew we had a good group of young ladies. They've been playing well for the last couple of years, and we knew they had the ability to get here. They just had not made it. We're just very proud of them and our school and our community for coming together and for us being able to be here tonight to participate in this great event.
Now, the way things seem for me in my travels, the bigger towns may not necessarily get wrapped up in this as much as the smaller towns. How has Perry responded to how things have been with the Panthers?
The community has been great this week. The spirit at the school has been great. I couldn't have asked for a community to support our kids any better than they have this week.
All right, let's go to the other side. Now, let's come over here and talk to the experienced veteran we hooked up 2 years ago when Tasha was a mere freshman. Now she's a junior, Dave Shoemake. What's it been like for Gainesville this time around getting here to the Coliseum?
Well, Gainesville, you know, is proud of its athletic program, its academic program, and fine arts program. And John, getting back here to Macon and in the finals, you know, it's kind of routine for us. And so what we want to do, we want to leave here tonight another state champion. So in our community, John, our fans and all the Red Elephants that are out there, love what we're doing right now. We've got a great group of girls. Coach Hill's done a great job. They've been together a long time. And so our expectations are to win, and our expectations are to come to Macon every year.
Now, with the way things have been with the Elephants, you know, it's a storied high school and a storied program. I guess talk about how Gainesville has kind of taken the identity of the school and of the team coming down here this whole year.
Well, we've had a great year, and we've had one now for the last 3 years. And so, you know, our community comes and supports our kids in each and every way. I mean, we have a great athletic association, a great staff, and so our teachers get behind them. We have T-shirt sales. We believe two things motivate kids, food and T-shirts. And so this week we've had great T-shirt sales, and we enjoy coming to the Macon Coliseum.
And also a basketball championship to
That's
go with
right.
it. Dave Shoemake. And besides, I want T-shirts too. Just kidding. I'm a kid at heart. Bobby, thanks for your time. Dave, thanks for your time. Jim, thanks for your time. Back to you.
And thank you for your time, John. Well, I tell you what, if Perry wins a basketball championship, that'd be their second championship in 5 weeks. Perry's cheerleading squad won the cheerleading championships about 5 weeks ago right here on GPTV. All right, we had some great first half highlights. And for those highlights, we go to Dave Gardner and Teresa Edwards.
All right, thanks, Jim. A big first half indeed. A one-point ball game here, 21-20 Perry over Gainesville right now. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of the highlights that set the pace there in that first half.
I thought Tassie came out and played very well for Perry. She had some nice jump shots. She also got out in open court. Gainesville, on the other hand, they had some great quarter wear in the bus, Tasha, and then she pushed it up and got a few layups for her team. Number 14, Hendricks stepped up and made a couple big shots for Gainesville as well. Davis back with Perry. She's been pounding on the inside and doing her job. And then once again, like I said, Tassie, she's been out in open court. That's her game. She wants to help create some turnovers on defense so that she can lay the ball.
Check out the bank shot here, too.
And this was a big, nice.
Gotta love that.
She forgot to call it, but we'll give it to her.
Of course, Gainesville on the other end with a big three of their own. Hendricks,
Hendricks again.
Knocking one down as well.
Really big shots.
Let's go ahead and take a look at the stats there from that first half. As you see, the field goal is a little slow there. Only 24% from the field for Gainesville. Perry a little bit better at 36. Of course, rebounds pretty much even. The turnover picture is pretty much even as well. Free throws, teams picking it up a little bit there. But so far, I guess it's safe to say it's been a pretty even game.
It has been. It's been a surprisingly even game. And I think Perry's done a great job of containing Tasha Humphrey so far. Like Coach Chance said before going into halftime, he has rotated different players on her. Even though they're outmatched, outsized, they're getting the job done.
All right, well, let's go ahead and step aside here. We'll be right back as we get set for second half action. AAA Girls resumes right after this.
Broadcast of GHSA Basketball on GPTV is made possible in part by the following corporate partners.
You're watching GPTV, bringing you the best.
You're watching the GHSA Basketball State Championships on GPTV.
Back here at the Megan Centerplex as we get set for third quarter action. Quickly, let's throw it on down to John Nelson. John, what's up?
Just talked to Manson Hill real quick. He's worried about Shantina Davis. Needs to find a way to shut her down here in the next 16 minutes. He thought he was getting good looks, but he needs more inside presence and less outside presence offensively. Back to you.
All right, there you go. And that's kind of what you talked a little bit about there at halftime there. Both teams looking to step it up in this third quarter and pick up the pace.
It'll definitely be interesting because Shantina Davis really picked it up the pace before it half.
We're going to look at the leaders for Gainesville. Humphrey with 9 points, Hendricks with five, and Niles with four. And for Perry, that's Marina Davis with 7 points, Mitchell with six, and a couple of players with 4 points. And Williams and Shantina Davis.
And Perry does a great job with some balanced scoring, so I'm not surprised by that one, that's for sure. Which is a good thing for any team when all your players can score.
Exactly. Exactly. There's Humphrey now over in the corner. Westmoreland. Inside, tough turnaround for Hendricks. Too strong, won't go, but Gainesville keeps it alive underneath.
Tasha was there, and she grabbed the rebound, put it back. Hendricks is playing with a lot of confidence.
Yes, she is. Without a doubt, Hendricks, a junior, trying to take it home. Oh, and a big block there by Humphrey.
She came out the paint for that one.
And then Humphrey hits the floor there. Foul from behind. They're going to get Williams, it looks like, for a push. You know, as of course, the big, as Jim alluded to, as we get a look at the block there by Humphrey. Of course, a big championship month, I guess, with the cheerleading team for Perry winning the state. Of course, the basketball team here looking to add a title. Of course, Gainesville right there as well, trying to add another title. Their baseball team, of course, is always winning the state championship, it seems like. A shot from outside off the marker a little bit, rattled in and out of there for Mandy Smith.
That was a great shot attempt from Mandy. She read that zone very well, and they gave her a lot of space to take that shot. I've seen her hit that shot. Perry's sitting back in that 1-3-1 on that possession. And we got Gainesville. They're matching up with Perry.
And a pull-up jumper in the lane off the block by Mitchell. Foul was there for Fatima Stripling.
Big rebound, good put back.
First points of the night for Stripling, averaging 10.5 a game.
Tassie still, she's coming out, firing him up. She's going to let that ball go. But she makes it happen when she does.
Humphrey now outside, pulls up. Too strong off the glass. But Niles keeps it alive. Good bounce there for Gainesville. Waller kicks it back out to Smith. Inside, Humphrey trying to get position, puts it up.
Very
good
call.
And a jump ball call. Possession arrow will stay with Gainesville.
Very good call.
Good defense, though, by Marina Davis.
She just stuck her hand in there in hopes that the ref said jump ball.
So off the inbound here. Oh, nice pass underneath. Blocked from behind, though. And back the other way. Big time block there by Shantina Davis.
That was a great read for Tasha Humphrey, finding her teammate under the basket wide open. Just a little slow shot. Got blocked.
Tassie Mitchell from outside. No good. And now another jump ball call.
I'll tell you, the scouting report for Perry may say they are not a good outside shooting team, but it never did say they wouldn't shoot it.
Exactly.
Because Tassie is putting it up.
They're not trigger shy at all, that's for sure. I'll tell you what.
I like it. I love it, actually.
Thought I might see him run a little bit more, though, trying to run the floor a little bit.
You're exactly right. Usually they're extending that full court pressure and trying to create those turnovers because they do love those fast break opportunities.
23-22, 1-point Perry lead here with 5:16 to go in the third quarter. That's Stripling cross court to Davis. Davis pulls back out, being guarded by Waller. And now Williams will reset up top.
Good to see him be patient, but they still got to attack with some intensity.
Shot partially blocked by Waller. Now a whistle underneath and a push going to be called on Perry. And I believe that's going to be another foul on Marimi Davis. It's going to be her third. Davis gives you that size underneath. And now she will come out with those three fouls.
I just kind of knew fouls was going to be a factor, especially inside the paint. I'd like to see Perry try to go at Tasha in the same manner and trying to get her in foul trouble. They're not really doing that anymore. We thought they would do that as they started the first quarter.
King replaces Davis in the lineup. Lady Elephants with the basketball. Waller. Smith with it. Into the hands of Humphrey. Turn around. Shot won't quite go.
That was good defense. She couldn't block her shot. There's no way she was going to do that, but she was there with a hand in Tasha's face, which made that shot harder for Tasha to make.
You know, I guess she could hit all over the floor, but if you have to, you'd rather make her have to shoot from outside. You'd rather make her take those shots.
You'd rather make anyone shoot from outside, for sure.
And a rebound there off the miss. Lady Panthers unable to convert.
Somebody needs to pick the ball up. There we go.
And that one too tall, looking for Hurst, the senior underneath there, but pass too high.
I'd like to see Mandy Smith get more into the game and make something happen for Gainesville. I think she's just one of those confident players, and I like when she has the ball in her hand because I think she has control. And I think she does a great job of finding Tasha when Tasha's most vulnerable to scoring. That takes the pressure off of Tasha where she doesn't have to bring the ball down.
Tipped.
Rainbow.
Nice work. Shot way off there going for glass again. Wouldn't go. That's Tassie Mitchell with it.
And here's Tassie.
Foul going to be called.
Like I said, that kid's going to be everywhere. She's a hustle player.
Foul going to be on Westmoreland. We talk about Region 7 AAA. We saw the East Hall boys warming up at halftime here of this AAA Girls Championship. East Hall, of course, out of Region 7 AAA. A lot of basketball tradition for the Vikings. Taking on Hart County, the Bulldogs.
You're filling up this Coliseum right now.
Yeah. Of course, that'll be the final championship. Another foul called underneath. That's going to be two on Humphrey. Yeah, championship weekend. Of course, this is number nine of 10 championships playing out over the last couple of days. A busy weekend of high school basketball in the state of Georgia.
It's been some great basketball, though.
Oh, yeah.
I'll tell you
great
that.
Games.
Great games.
Good close games, too, including this one right here, 23-22. Can't ask for anything better. Not a lot of offense, a low-scoring game, obviously. Nonetheless, a close and exciting one that more than likely will come down to the wire again.
You know it.
That's all we've seen. Overtime, of course, in the AA girls. I think we had overtime in the Quad A girls game last night up at Tech.
Oh, we're not talking overtime. Well, you never know.
Humphrey, the
great power move. That's what Tasha has to do. She has to turn around, get her position, establish herself, go straight up strong, and get her buckets. She can't really worry about the little girls that are playing around her knees right now. She's got to play basketball.
Humphrey with a baker's dozen now for the Lady Elephants. Starting to heat up a little bit. That pass too high intended for Tassie Mitchell. And the ball will go back over to the Lady Elephants. So Gainesville with a one-point lead now, 24-23. The lead swapped here a little bit.
First chance coach in his life.
Whistle on the floor. 21 20 at halftime was the score. Perry with a one-point lead, and not a lot has happened since then here in this third quarter. Gainesville with 4 points, and Perry with just a bucket in this third quarter, and it's about 2.5 minutes left. George Hendricks kicks it out. Humphrey puts up the shot, won't quite go. Hendricks in position, and gonna draw the foul inside.
Great hustle by Hendricks. He read no one's checking off on the boards again. No one's putting bodies on anyone, and Hendricks just crashed the board real hard and came up with a really big rebound. That was great.
That's a third foul on Shatina Davis, as you can look at it again.
No one, just straight there. You better believe. After a rebound like that, everyone's going to crash you. Obviously, a little more strength, she could have had an and-one on that one.
And Davis will have to come out of the lineup. She'll sit with those three fouls as Fairfax checks back in. And you get a look at the numbers on Hendricks, who rattles that free throw. So 7 points now for Taurus Hendricks, the junior.
He's playing with the confidence of a junior, I believe. No wonder she's playing with that confidence. I like her game. She's looking very athletic and playing strong.
Nearing the two-minute mark here in this third quarter. 26-23 steal. Hendricks on the other end.
Oh, nice left-hand.
Left-hander.
Great fundamental basketball, but let me tell you, that was a nice left-handed shot. Strong take.
30-second timeout going to be called by Coach John Chance. And the Perry Lady Panthers and Gainesville has extended their lead to 5 at 28-23 with 1:56 to play in this third quarter.
And they're doing it as a team tonight. It's not just a Tasha Humphrey show that we thought it would be. Great steal. Hendricks got into passing lane. She read that perfectly. Went hard. Nice left leg.
That's a tough shot. Two defenders trailing.
Doesn't get any better than that. That was tough, but she was going to take that. That was nothing but determination on her face.
They get a look at Hendricks, a little smile there as she came back on the floor there.
So would I.
King into the lineup for Perry there. And Lady Panthers will inbound, trailing by 5 now. So a little bit of work cut out for him here. Gainesville, 6 straight points.
Let's hope this timeout paid off for Perry. They did need that one. They need to settle in. They need to make great opportunities and take advantage of every offensive opportunity that they get, because we're getting down to the wire where everything counts and everything matters.
As you saw, a 6-0 run there by Gainesville. In the last 4.5 minutes, 1:35 on the clock here in the third. And a turnover going back to the Lady Elephants.
They're only getting one-shot opportunities here lately on the offensive end of the floor, so they've got to convert those shots that they do get.
That's Waller with the basketball, the freshman, who, as we mentioned, has played a big part in this state. That one by Humphrey off the mark from the corner. Waller with 11 points against Dodge County. Dodge, of course, out of Region 4 AAA, the same region as Perry, so we almost had a Region 4 final in AAA this year, an all Region 4 final.
Games that make the game against Dodge County look so easy. I thought maybe they would make this one look easy, but I'm really impressed with Perry tonight.
Oh, what a pass to Humphrey inside to Keita Waller.
Okay, there's my point guard skill where I can just dish a dime.
And again, she's only a junior, folks.
That was nice. Oh.
Tassie Mitchell on the other end. Kicks it back out, a near turnover there. Fairfax with it. Fairfax hit that three-point shot last night with 5 seconds on the clock. Putting Perry right here in the state championship game. That one off the mark. Back on the other end. That's Waller all alone. Lays it up and in.
Great awareness by Tasha Humphrey again. And automatically when Tasha grabs the rebound, she's looking up court. She's trying to find who's out front. If there's someone out front, that ball is leaving. That's exactly what happened that time.
And she put that thing in there like Mike Vick.
She throws it really
good. That one partially blocked by Waller. Humphrey on the other end. Gonna run the floor. Kicks the ball still loose. Picked up by Fairfax. Now Perry with a three-on-one. Too tall. They had Stripling underneath, but the pass too high, and the ball goes back over.
Three-on-one opportunity. Kind of looked at the court a little too late for that one.
So 4 seconds left on the clock here in this third quarter, and Gainesville has extended their lead 32-23. And at the buzzer, Hurst going to be short on that one. And that is going to do it for the quarter. But what a quarter for the Lady Elephants of Gainesville. They lead it 32-23 with 8 minutes to go. We'll be right back to Macon after this.
Broadcast of GHSA Basketball on GPTV is made possible in part by the following corporate partners. You're watching the GHSA Basketball State Championships on GPTV.
Set and ready for fourth quarter action of this AAA Girls Championship. Let's quickly throw it back to John Nelson. John, what's up?
Gainesville right now on a 10-0 run as we get to the fourth quarter. Spend some time listening to John Chance. He says, get back to your offense in the post, and he wants Marimi Davis to get aggressive but not to pick up a cheap fourth foul. Back to you.
All right, Gainesville having a little bit of trouble there on the inbound, so Mandy Smith wisely calls a quick 30-second timeout, and Gainesville will hang on to the basketball. But in that third quarter, a slow one for Perry.
Very slow. They're 1-for-10 from the field right now, and that's not a good thing. Hopefully, they're, you know, Coach Chance put in his starters. They're all on the court right now, beginning of the fourth quarter. They're going to come out and give it their all. That's all they can really do, but they've got to hit these open baskets. They've got to make the layups. They've got to convert everything, a free throw. You know, if you can bounce it off the floor and it goes in, that'll work too.
As long as it's going in that cylinder there.
But they've got to put in a great effort here and limit as many turnovers as much as possible, not to make any turnovers here at this point in the game.
Kentucky Gainesville cheerleaders. Gainesville outscoring Perry 12-2 in that third quarter as we begin the final 8 minutes of play here at the Macon Centerplex. And what a weekend of championship basketball right here on GPTV. 10 championship games. This is the ninth one. One more to follow the AAA Boys Championship.
Good man-to-man coverage by Perry there, Dave. I tell you, they came up with a good rebound. They're making Tasha turn around and take shots. Maybe she doesn't necessarily want to take, but I don't know. It feels rushed, but she's got a hand in her face when she shoots. It's a great start for a fourth quarter.
Pull-up jumper in and out of there for Stripling. But she follows her own side. Good hustle there. Keeps it alive for Perry.
Davis kept it alive. She tapped it out, and they came up with it.
Shatina Davis won't go. Humphrey down there with it. Looking for the outlet down court.
Great get back. Way to get back on defense for Perry. They came up with the steal. They're not going to let that happen so easy anymore. That's good. It's great awareness. Great adjustment.
Tassie Mitchell from outside. In and out there on the three-point shot. Man.
Heartbreaker. That wasn't in and out of him.
32-23, Gainesville.
Gotta love Tassie's heart. Gotta love her heart.
Tita Waller, give it over to Smith. Number 44, Lindsay Thompson, the senior, in the lineup for Gainesville. Check in after that timeout. Shot from outside is there. Tita Waller, three-pointer.
Big shot, nice shot.
The freshman with
not
7 points.
Like one.
Man. You'd never know it, would you?
No, you wouldn't, and that's a good thing. Does she know she's in the state championship?
Probably not. It hadn't hit her yet at all. That's Williams with it up top. Back over to Mitchell. And the Lady Panthers trying to get back in this thing. Shatina Davis puts up the shot. Tough shot. Won't go. Thompson with it. And once again, Humphrey will slow it down.
Just wouldn't go for Shatina. That was a great penetration.
They're going to look at the run. It's been a day of streaks. 13-0 run in the last 8 minutes for Gainesville. Shot off the mark back on the other end. 2-on-2 for Perry. The bank shot won't quite go. Big block from behind, but I believe they're going to get Humphrey for the foul, and that's going to be her third.
You're not going to win that battle, Tarzan. That one from behind. If he blows it, it's definitely against you.
Coach John Chance said it best at halftime. She's good. What can you say about Humphrey?
She is. She is. Highly sought after. Definitely good. There's definitely room for improvement. Don't get me wrong, but she's a good player.
So, Shantina Davis, the junior, averaging right around 12 points a game this year at the line, hits first. And now back into the lineup there for Gainesville. Niles, Westmoreland in there as the 13-0 run comes to an end with that free throw by the Lady Panthers there. 5 points for Davis today, 6 boards. She's really been all over the floor today.
She has. Night. She played a great game last night. She had 12 points for her team.
And the shot is there for Davis, 6 points now for Shantina Davis. 35-25, 10-point game, 5:45 to go.
A lot of game left, a lot of time.
Shot tipped, partially blocked. Out of bounds.
I'm feeling a level of intensity from Perry right now that they really didn't have in that third quarter, which propelled Gainesville to take the lead that they have now. Came out a little flat at half after halftime, I guess. And hey, now they got to fight to get themselves into this thing.
Now that's Westmoreland from outside. Three-point shot out of there. And now a whistle on the floor, and it looks like it's going to be called on Davis. Santina Davis, it looks like, going to pick up the foul there. Actually, that's number 11, Fatima Stripler.
One of those hustle fouls.
Off the inbound, Humphrey underneath with the position there. 15 points now for Tasha.
She just stepped in there and outside me and Nika Williams and just posted up, easy shot, position herself. That was almost too easy.
Looking inside off the fingertips of Marimi Davis, couldn't quite hold it.
Davis couldn't pull it in, but that was a good pass.
Waller off the pass from Westmoreland now. Westmoreland back up top.
Good patience. No need to rush it. Run your offense. Play basketball.
Inside, Miles, turn around. Tough shot. Won't go. Davis with the board. And Shantina Davis back and running the other way. Pulls up for three. Short. Follow. Davis won't go. Stripling is there, and she'll draw the foul. Good work by Perry underneath. Man, they are fighting.
They are fighting, but they've got to settle down and take smart shots. Great effort inside. They're going for it. They have not given up, and they will not give up until this clock and the buzzer just go on. Because I tell you what, if Coach Chance can do anything right now, it's to settle them down and tell them it's not desperation time. There's plenty of time left in the game to make something happen. Take the smart shots. We can get some and-ones inside the paint there with Davis.
Timeout, full timeout on the floor with 4:29 to play. 37-25, Gainesville on top. Again, Gainesville out of Region 7 AAA comes in at 29-3, number 5 in the state. Perry, the number 4 ranked team. The latest poll there, 29-2 coming in. The Lady Panthers, of course, out of Region 4 AAA. And again, a great matchup here taking place in the AAA Girls Championship. Well, all of the state basketball championships can be seen live on the GPB website at www.gpb.org. Now, all games will also be archived and available at a later date. While you're there, show your support by signing up to become a member of GPTV. That's www.gpb.org. Always fun to watch those archived games. You can go back, and it really gives an opportunity for the folks that are here in this building to go back and take a look at what it looked like on TV. Hats off, too, to the Georgia High School Association. Ralph Swearinge and those guys doing an excellent job. And, of course, things can sometimes get a little crazy when you got this many people, you know, in the course of a couple days, 10 finals. But hats off to the Georgia High School Association.
I'm telling you, nothing gets more pure than the games of this nature, because you bring so many different communities in one central location. It's been a beautiful thing. I tell you what, I've seen some great fans come in this building.
So Stripling at the line after the timeout. And gets the first one to go. Nothing but net there. Hats off, too, as we mentioned, to this GPTV production crew, man. They have hung in there, done a great job. It's always a long weekend, and they've really hung in there.
They really have. Of course, no one sees them back in the back sleeping, huh?
Exactly.
Nah, they really do a great job. I'm telling you, a lot of work.
Stripling 2 of 2 on that last trip. She's got 4 points now, and the lead is back to 10. We'll get a look at the field goal percentage right there. 35% for Gainesville, 24 for Perry. Perry just one field goal in that second half.
Now that 24% is not going to get it done today. Normally, they have extended their defense. They are playing intense. They're trying to come up with this ball, get their hands out on the ball, create some deflection, and hopefully go to the other end and get some baskets back.
Well, like you said, Perry, not much of an outside shooting team. Granted, they do shoot from out there, but they're more of the scoring comes from inside, so normally they don't have that low of a percentage. 24, you know, normally they take those higher percentage shots, I guess.
You're absolutely right. Normally they're actually getting more layups usually in their games.
Right. Gainesville, of course, up by 10, only shooting 34%. So, you know, they'd like to pick it up because there's still plenty of time left here, 3.5 minutes to go. Slowed down the pace a little bit. Perry picked up the defensive intensity here a little bit. Feeling a sense of urgency right now, though. Mandy Smith resets up top for Gainesville.
Now it's a Gainesville team that's taking care of the ball, being poised, and really working their offense and working the clock at the same time.
Humphrey too tall, trying to force that thing in there to Waller, but it wasn't there. And now Coach John Chance going to call a 30-second timeout. Coach Manson Hill trying to add another state championship to that Lady Elephant Trophy case. And right now, Gainesville's in good shape up by 10. But Perry, as we mentioned, they've got the athletes. They've got the players to have the ability to get back in this ballgame, make some baskets.
They really do, but they cannot afford to allow Gainesville to control the ball and have the ball in the offensive end of the floor as long as they just had it, because that's running time off the clock in which they're going to need to make up 10 points, which is a lot for a team that doesn't convert many baskets from three-point land. So they got to get a lot of inside three-point plays or, you know, get to the basket really quick here. Given the clock, there's plenty of time. There's definitely plenty of times, but not much time if you're going to make turnovers or not convert your field goals.
Go ahead and take a look at some earlier scores from today, kind of get you caught up on what all has happened. Of course, we're starting out the day with, or last night actually, at Georgia Tech in Atlanta, and in the Quad A Girls Championship, it was Mays with a 5-point overtime victory for the state championship there over Hepzibah. And then, of course, Griffin with a 10-point victory over South Atlanta in the Quad A Boys game, a very exciting game. 5A Parkview getting it done over Stevenson, 43-37. And in the boys' game, of course, Wheeler, 63-56, back-to-back state championships for Wheeler and 5A. Then, of course, on to Saturday earlier today right here in Macon, Taylor County winning the single-A girls' championship. And then after that, it was the Whitfield Academy, 83-72 over Southwest Atlanta Christian, and quite a ball game there. And, of course, Early County over Randolph Clay, final in overtime in the double-A girls' game. Mitchell Baker over Decatur in the double-A boys' game. That was fun to watch as well. And here we are right here in the triple-A girls' matchup.
Oh, unfortunate turnover there for Gainesville. Perry's working really hard. They were really patient. They came off out of the timeout. They went inside the paint. They got a good look at the basket. Just didn't go for them. Gainesville, no need to rush their game at this point in time with a 10-point lead and throw it out of bounds like that. They've got to play smart basketball as well.
Perry, meanwhile, picking up the pace a little bit offensively here. Davis from outside. Won't quite go. And the ball going to go over to Gainesville. Last touch by the Lady Panthers. And it looked like Fairfax may have turned an ankle there or something, but she's walking it off.
And Hendricks got a little lower body bump on her on this rebound possession here. Kind of threw her body into it, but got away with it. So
Gainesville with the basketball. And the lead, Humphrey.
And one lady you don't want to have it.
Boom. Oh, what a move. Oh. Natasha Humphrey.
Up and under, got to have one today.
That's a highlight reel right there.
That was nice.
What a move. And then back on the other end. Going to be Gainesville basketball.
Once again, you can't just go down and give them the ball. You can't make it that easy for a good team like Gainesville.
I'm speechless after that last one. I don't know how to describe that.
Great hustle. Oh.
Perry's trying to chip away, but time's running out here. 2:17 left in the ballgame. Coach John Chance's first season at Perry, guiding the Lady Panthers to the state championship game.
Perry's giving their heart and soul to this game. You can tell. You can see it on their face. You want them to know at this point in stage, with 2 minutes left in the game, you still have a chance, but you got to stay focused. You got to make smart decisions.
Cassie Mitchell called for her third foul, and now she'll pick up her fourth. Right there.
They're at a stage now where they're playing almost desperation basketball, and that's not a smart game to play at 2 minutes left in the game. That's plenty of time. It's plenty of time to get some shots up, force the issue, attack the basket, put Gainesville on the hill, and hopefully get to the free throw line. That can make a difference in 2 minutes. I think it can make a big difference over the outcome of this game if they really think that way right now.
Gainesville in the 1-1, 17 fouls on Perry. Westmoreland at the line hits the first. And Fairfax in for the Lady Panthers. That's the first point of the night for Westmoreland. And hits both. So 2 for 2 on the trip there. Makes it 41-27. Gainesville in control here. Now Perry.
I'm feeling really good about it with Humphrey on the bench.
Yep.
That's the penetration. That's what they need right there.
Tina Davis kissing that one off the glass there.
And good defense. Timeout. Forcing them to call that timeout. Very good defense.
Timeout by the Lady Elephants there as you get a look at this last bucket by Perry.
That's the penetration shots we need right there. We need to convert those. Continue to attack. If you don't get any contact, make the bucket. You get the contact, get the and one.
Kind of taking a look at the road. Gainesville in round one with a 50-point victory over Cedartown. 67-38, they cruised over Towers. And then round three over Elbert County. And, of course, the victory last night over Dodge County. Friday night at 7:30 p.m., it's Georgia's longest-running high school sports and academics program. That's Prep Sports Plus. You'll meet some of Georgia's most successful student-athletes, athletic programs, and much more. Again, Prep Sports Plus Fridays at 7:30 p.m. exclusively on GPTV. I enjoy watching that. Jim Giannacchio, as I mentioned, does a great job with that. I know he's over there smiling right now. He does an excellent job with that program, as well as all the folks that report, and a very entertaining show. And certainly good for high school athletics in the state of Georgia.
Good pressure. Got to come up with those loose balls.
Nearly got the turnover there.
Will
foul Catherine Hurst and put her on the line.
I thought they had that steal. It would have been great coming out of timeout.
Look at that right there. Perry has only scored two field goals in the entire second half. There's 1:53 left to play in the ballgame. And that, you know, we can talk about stats, this, that, and the other, but bottom line, that ball's got to go through the hoop at the end of the night.
That's the tell of the tape. That's the ball game, I tell you. That will do it for you. Any reason to think we're going to score a minute and 53 seconds on the clock? 10 or more points if we haven't scored but two buckets?
That's a tough one right there. Waller back in the lineup. Andy Smith will take a seat. The senior. Hurst hitting on the first one. And she knocks down both. So Hurst, another senior, with a pair of free throws. And Hurst will come out of the lineup now.
This Gainesville team has played a great game tonight. And I'll tell you, they played as a team. It's been a joy to watch them, because you would think it would be a Tasha Humphrey show every night. But she gives her teammates just as much as credit.
Sarah Westmoreland up with the steal. For Gainesville, Humphrey.
Nice pass.
Inside, Waller. Oh, shot won't quite go. Waller follows her own shot, though, and hits.
Tell you what, Tasha does a great job of reading the defense, but that was a really nice, smooth bounce pass in the paint.
So Waller figures, and there's a big three-point shot right there by the Lady Panthers. That's what they need.
There we go.
Tassie Mitchell.
Tassie's been putting them up. They haven't all fallen tonight, but I tell you what, there has been a few, and that's a big one there. That's a good one for her. All net.
So still a minute 20 left. Anything can happen. Gainesville very much in control, but as I mentioned, Perry's got the athletes to get back in this thing. Taking a look at what the Lady Panthers did. They cruised in round one over Westside Augusta, and then a tight ball game, just a one-point victory over Tattnall County in round two. Then a six-point win over Westover. Mitchell had 10 points in that ball game, and in the semis, that two-point victory, that thriller over Westminster right there at the buzzer in the semifinals, putting Perry right here in the state championship.
Yeah, maybe that game took something out of Perry that they couldn't gear up and play for a team like Gainesville, because Westminster was a great team. They play really hard, great team, great players. And that happens sometimes. You can maybe underestimate some teams that you feel overconfident at times. But Westminster, really, they had some great players. That was a great game, exciting game. Hate to see them go out like that. Gainesville, they actually beat Gainesville during the season. So
right.
I'm sure they would have enjoyed an opportunity to play this game tonight. But
oh, what a pass.
Oh,
we're inside and a foul.
But it will be the Red Elephants putting on a show here at the end. Nice pass, nice convert.
Hurst with the bucket and the three-point opportunity now. Well, I tell you what, Humphrey can do it all. What a pass there, no look, over the shoulder, and Hurst wide open underneath.
Is this just looking like a 2 out of 3 championships for her so far?
I think so.
And I guess we'll see her next year too, huh?
Possibly, you never know. Several other players returning as well, and wow. Hurst completes the three-point play. So Catherine Hurst off the bench with 5 points here in the last couple minutes. 48-32 with 1:12 left. Shot from outside. That's Williams. 3-point shot off the mark. Won't go. Stripling keeps it alive. Shantina Davis drives, has it knocked away, and a foul going to be called. So Perry streak of 16 straight wins in jeopardy here tonight.
Good to see Gainesville they haven't conceded as if they're champions already. They're out there still battling out, still getting on each other.
Look at that. Coach LA, he looks like it's a tie ball game with a minute left. The look on his face right there. He's still coaching.
You can't blame him. That's the competitive spirit of the game.
Davis with 8 points and rattles that one in there. So a good night all around for Shantina Davis, who's been very busy. Niles with the ball for Gainesville. And a foul going to be called on Perry. 55 seconds left. And it's pretty elementary right now. Gainesville with a 15-point lead.
We're feeling the victory. It's hard to hold it, I'm sure.
Warren Niles at the line here again. Coming up, Triple A boys action. You won't want to miss it again. Hart County and East Hall for the final championship of championship weekend, if you will, in the state of Georgia right here on GPTV. A look at some of the Gainesville fans in attendance tonight.
Look at some of the balanced scoring as well as from Gainesville. Good to see the output of the teammates. I'll tell you what, it's been a good game. It's been a great team win. Unless a miracle happened in 54 seconds.
Humphrey there on the rebound after the missed free throw, and now Humphrey will have a shot at the line here. 53 seconds left. Take your hats off to Perry, though. What an athletic season it's been, especially winning that cheerleading championship. Of course, the girls here making this weekend, playing some basketball. And, of course, Gainesville also a big year. Their football team going to the Dome. The baseball team, I think, has won 5 out of the last 7 state championships or something like that.
I'll tell you what, though. These young ladies from Perry have played some championship game to get themselves here. They are, you know, as I always say, you're all winners once you get to this level and once you get to this stage of the game.
3-point shot there by Ashley Fairfax. That
and they have not quit.
No, they haven't.
Which I love.
That's certainly been a trademark of this Perry basketball team.
You know, for some of the seniors, it's their last chance. You know, for some of the other players, they may have an opportunity to go further. But this is going to be a heavy game on their hearts. You can believe that. Of course, Gainesville going to, you know, raise the roof in a couple seconds here. But
44 seconds, I guess.
Yeah, but you know, I always hate to see the other team hanging their heads when there's really no need for it because somebody's going to win, somebody's going to lose. Of course, it took me 4 years of high school to get to a state championship game and win. So, you know, it's a lot of work. I guess that's why you take a lot of pride in it when you do win.
Exactly, exactly. A lot of people don't see what goes behind the scenes. So some of these teams practice early in the morning before school or a couple hours afterwards or whatever. And it's hard. You got to remember, this is high school. They got to juggle athletics and academics. And that makes it even tougher, too. So, I mean, take your hats off to all of them.
Exactly.
So Frank Malloy's done a good job feeding us some stats here tonight. Certainly want to thank him. And all the folks with this GPTV crew. Certainly been fun. I've had a great weekend. A lot of good games, a lot of close games. State championships and some memorable moments indeed provided here in 2003. As the Lady Elephants get the ball in, and Humphrey will go back at the line now in a double bonus here. She'll have 2 shots.
It's a matter of padding the stats now, right?
Yep. Humphrey sitting on 18 points right now. Had a very slow first half. She's only 1 of 9 field goals in that first quarter.
You know, Perry did a great job in the first half containing her. Or maybe, you know, she's probably feeling as if she just didn't have a good out in the first half. As most great players do.
Lauren Niles out of the lineup for Gainesville. And she gets some hugs from her teammates there. Lindsay Thompson, number 44, back in. And Humphrey again with 19 points and rattles in and out of there.
12 rebounds and some assists for the big girl.
Davis pulls up for 3 and hits. And Tina Davis in double figures.
She looks at that shot like, I'll be darned. Now you want to go in.
12 points tonight for Davis. She's got her season average. And another foul in the backcourt there is going to put Mandy Smith at the line. 19 seconds left. 51-39. Gainesville Lady Elephants. They've been to the semifinals, been to the Final Four the last 3 years. They won it in 2001, and a couple years later, it looks like they're going to add another title.
Coach Chance takes Davis out of the game, but she really played a great game. She played her heart out. You know, it didn't go the way she wanted it to go, but you're just a junior kid. You can make it happen again next year.
Humphrey comes out of the game and is congratulated by our teammates.
That's the big dog over there. Getting it done.
Vandy Smith misses on the first one there. Therese, it's certainly been fun. I've enjoyed working with you. Had fun in that double-A game, and it's carried over to this triple-A game. Some good games.
I've enjoyed you as well.
Some good athletes indeed on the floor. We've got to watch some of the best ones, and of course, Tasha Humphrey is certainly a treat. And,
of course, I'm always excited to watch young talent. has become my life since retiring. Watch the young talent.
You're not old enough to retire now. Right?
Hey, tell my legs that.
Yeah. You got a few years left in there. Oh, man. You talk about Region 7 AAA. As we said, of course, East Hall boys coming up. We talk about some of the other teams ranked there all year long. But Perry, I tell you what, they've been there. They've got a tough region there. Dodge County, of course, in the semifinals, and tells you the level of competition that they play in all year long, too. As you see some of the fans
trying to
celebrate here a little bit.
I tell you what, they are shifting in and out and stay full all day. It's been exciting. Oh, my goodness. It's been some great basketball, I tell you.
Oh, yeah. Here you look at Gainesville.
How are they containing? I mean, come on. 19 seconds?
Yeah, we saw early
respect.
County. Well, we saw early County. You know, they were jumping around.
I know. 2 seconds left.
Early.
They're already on the court. You can't blame early County. I mean, I guess Gainesville quite experienced at championships.
Exactly. Like the principal said, you know, they've been here before. They would just want to have another title. You know, just
even he sound experienced at championships.
Exactly. You know, business as usual there.
This is what we expect. That's what I'm talking about. It's the only way to be a champion is to expect to be one.
Buchholz in the game for Perry, number 25, as well as number 31, Stacey Askew, number 34, Brittany Walker in there, and a bucket for Perry. Also number 12, Katnella Scott.
Oh, there we go.
And that is going to do it.
Celebration begins.
The final seconds.
Oh!
And a mob at midcourt. Final 52-41. Congratulations to the Gainesville Lady Red Elephants of Gainesville, Georgia, your 2003 GHSA AAA state champions. Let's go ahead and throw it on down to John Nelson, standing by with a winning coach.
Thanks, Dave. The tie is still undefeated. Does it get retired now?
No, I think we'd rather bring it back one more year. The tie is still doing good, and our team did great. We made a couple adjustments at halftime, and we just did a great job in the second half, and I'm really excited.
Now, Tasha started out, I think, one for her first nine, a great defensive effort that you ended up working your way through as we got through the second half.
Exactly. I mean, it's team ball, you know, and you know, our other players stepped up. Tasha stepped up. We did some other things, you know, and made some adjustments on that, too. So, you know, I mean, I don't care who scores what points. All I want is Gainesville to have more than the other team, you know, and we did that tonight.
Two out of the last 3 years. When does it normally sink in that you get a championship, a T-shirt, and a hat?
You know, I feel extraordinarily blessed. This is the third one that we've been able to have in two out of the last 3 years, and we've been to three straight Final Fours. So, you know, this group has just been so much fun to coach, and they're just so determined, and they're so focused, and, you know, and I don't know how it gets any better.
All right, Manson Hill, congratulations. Second title. And that shirt, by the way, he wore that on Friday. He said he just ironed it. He didn't wash it, Jim. Nine down, one to go.
One more to go. The 3A Boys Championship is on deck here on GPTV. Gainesville wins it 52-41, their third state championship since 1994. For John Nelson, Dave Gardner, Teresa Edwards, and our entire technical team here in Macon, I'm Jim Giannacchio. Thanks for watching the 3A Girls Basketball Championship. Coming up next, the 3A Boys Championship. That's all next here on GPTV. Thanks for watching, everybody.
This broadcast of the Georgia High School Association State Basketball Championships has been made possible in part by Georgia's Electric Membership Corporations, IBEW Local 613, South Trust Bank, The Kroger Company, Dodge, State Farm Insurance, the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, and by the Atlanta Journal-Constitution.
Broadcast of GHSA Basketball on GPTV is made possible in part by the following corporate partners.